وما أدراك ما الحاق.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. أما بعد، respected viewers, welcome back once again to our program where we look at certain ayats and themes that we will be reciting in the Taraweeh. Inshallah, today we are looking at the 25th juz of the Holy Quran. And in the second ruku of this juz, we start a surah, which is known as Surah Shura. And Shura means consultation. And Allah has made mention of consultation as one of the qualities of the believer. فَمَا أُوتِيتُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَمَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَزِينَتُهَا. Whatever we have given you in this material world, it is part of the commodities of this world. وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرُ وَأَبْقَى. But whatever is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is better for you. It is more everlasting. But everlasting for who? Who take that particular message? لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Those who are believers. Who are the believers? وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. Those who rely upon Almighty Allah. وَالَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ كَبَائِرَ الْإِثْمِ وَالْفَوَاحِشِ. Who stay away from all types of evil. وَالَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ كَبَائِرَ الْإِثْمِ وَالْفَوَاحِشِ. They stay away from major sins and they stay away from immorality. وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُوهُمْ. When they are angry, even in the state of anger, they can forgive. Never ever allow yourself to be overwhelmed by anger that you do not know what you are doing. Allah says the believers, even when they are angry, they can forgive at the time of anger. وَالَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ. Those who respond to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's commands. وَالَّذِينَ اسْتَجَابُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ. And they established salat. وَأَمْرُهُمْ شُورَى بَيْنَهُمْ. That's why the surah is known as Surah Shura, that they matters are conducted by consultation. Consult with people with regard to your matters. This is a Quranic concept. In fact, the whole surah finds its name from this particular attribute. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ سَيِّئَةٌ مِثْلُهَا. That the recompense of the evil someone has done to you is you can do likewise. But remember, فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ. If you forgive and you reconcile, فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Your reward is with Allah. Your reward is with Allah. وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ. He who adopts patience and he forgives, it's an act of great courage. It's greater courage to forgive than to take revenge. Allah Ta'ala says, لِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. In the last few verses of Surah Shura, to Allah belongs the dominion and authority of the heavens and earth. يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاء. He creates whatever he wills. يَهَبُ لِمَا يَشَاءُ إِنَاثًا. He gives certain people male children, certain people female children, some people twins, or aqima, or he keep people without children. This is in the hands of Allah. So we should always ask Allah Ta'ala for children and our children to be obedient. Then the next surah is known as Surah Az-Zukhruf. Very interesting reason why it is known as Zukhruf. Allah Ta'ala, with regard to that verse from which the surah finds its name, before that Allah Ta'ala says, أَهُمْ يَقْسِمُونَ رَحْمَةَ رَبِّكَ. Allah Ta'ala is the one who distributes wealth amongst people. نَحْنُ قَسَمْنَا بَيْنَهُمْ مَعِيشَتَهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Allah Ta'ala says, I am the one who distributes wealth among people. وَرَفَعْنَا بَعْضَهُمْ فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ دَرَجَاتٍ. I give certain people more wealth compared to others. The disparity in income is an unavoidable fact. اللَّهُ يَبْسُطُ رِزْقَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. Allah expends, Allah restricts risk to whomsoever He wishes. Allah searches for such subtle wisdoms in giving people risk that we cannot understand. However, if Allah gives one more risk and more wealth than others, it does not mean that He is a favored servant of Allah. And look at how Allah has explained this aspect, this concept. وَلَوْلَا أَن يَكُونَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا. Had it not been that people would have followed one religion. وَلَوْلَا أَن يَكُونَ النَّاسُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا لَجَعَلْنَا. Allah says, I would have made, and I would have made freely available. لِمَن يَكْفُرُ بِالرَّحْمَنِ. For those who deny Allah, what would I have made freely available? لِبُيُوتِهِمْ سُقُفٌ مِّن فِضَّةٍ. I would have given them homes, the ceilings of which would have been made of silver. وَزُخْرُفَ. All types of adornments of this material world, I would have made available to those who deny Allah. But it would have been such a temptation that for the sake of that adornments, people would have queued up to deny Allah. So Allah has made mention, I distribute risk, but it doesn't mean that the one who I have given more is superior. Then Allah in the next ruku, the next two rukus, Allah has made mention of this point very beautifully in the verse 51 to 56, when He spoke about when Fir'aun taunted Musa alayhi salam. Viewers, I want you to listen to what Fir'aun told Musa. And then just remember, sometimes do we have the same mindset? وَنَادَى فِرْعَوْنُ فِي قَوْمِهِ قَالَ يَا قَوْمُ O my tribe, أَلَيْسَ لِي مُلْكُ مِصْرَ This country of Misr does not belong to me. وَهَذِي الْأَنْهَارُ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِي Look at this beautiful country. Look at the streams. أَمْ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِنْ هَذَا الَّذِي هُوَ مَهِينٌ وَلَا يَكَادُ يُبِينُ Am I better or is Musa alayhi salatu wasalam better who can't even speak and communicate properly? فَلَوْلَا أُلْقِيَ عَلَيْهِ أَسْوِرَةٌ مِّنْ ذَهَبٍ أَوْ جَاءَ مَعَهُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ مُقْتَرِنِينَ If he was truthful, why didn't he have gold? How many times you and I, we make the same type of conclusion? If Allah was happy with him, why didn't Allah Ta'ala make him wealthy? It's got nothing to do with superiority. And of course, thereafter we have Surah Dukhan. In Surah Dukhan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spoken about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's punishment, which will come in the form of smoke. There are different interpretations with regard to it, but Surah Dukhan is also a very, very significant surah. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has emphasized its recitation, especially on Friday night, the night which is between Thursday and Friday. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said, whoever recites Surah Dukhan, there are many angels who pray for his forgiveness. You know? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made mention with regard to the year after. And the last surah in the 25th juz of the Holy Quran is Surah Al-Jathiyah. And in there Allah ta'ala has made mention, أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهُ هُوَ وَأَذَلَّهُ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ Have you not seen those who have made their desires their Lord? Subhanallah. What does it mean that you have made your desires your Lord? It means that you obey your desires the way you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And really the core way of falling, you know, not falling into temptation is to curb your desires. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى He who fears standing before Almighty Allah and he prevents his desire from doing whatever he wants to do, then Jannah becomes his abode. Someone asked Ali radiallahu ta'ala, with which I will conclude today's program, how can we gain Jannah? Ali radiallahu ta'ala, blessed as he was with wisdom, said, very easy. Put your one step upon your desire, your next step, you are in Jannah. Control and curb your desires. Do not give it a free rein, because our desires are such, it leads us towards sin. So Allah Ta'ala says, أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهُ هَوَى Have you seen those who have made their desires their Lord? May Allah Ta'ala protect us. And may Allah Ta'ala, instead of following our desires, may Allah make us amongst those who follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا عَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ
الحاقة ما الحاقة وما أدراك ما الحاقة